So we now get to the fun part. My background is control engineering, and I'm always happy when I can do some control design. What we'd like to do is design our control algorithm and tune it based on time and frequency and requirement. So this will be for the voltage part. For the LEDs, it will be very similar, but we would like now to do it for the voltage control of our SAPIC. And we are going to use a different approach to what you usually see in our videos. This time we're going to use as a plant model a switched linear model, which cannot be linearized. And we will need to create a transfer function equivalent model and then tune it based on our requirement. Let's see this in action. So I prepared here a second model to talk about this. We have here our SimScale model. And actually, since I'm using a subsystem reference, which you can recognize as one of the two corners being cut, the top left and the bottom right, I'm referring to an external file called SAPIC circuit. This is a very powerful technique that allows me to reuse complex system using different files. This can be very useful when you're working in larger team and somebody needs to develop specific version of a subcomponent. It doesn't want to use a library, doesn't want to work within a huge, large single file for version control reason. So you can actually break down your physical model using a subsystem reference. Let's take a look on this on our documentation. It's a very interesting technique for when your system's starting to get really big and you want to split it out in multiple files. Now, here I have my controller. It's not only the PI, there is some switches as well, depending on if I enable the closed loop or not, the ability to output only zero, maybe for safety reasons, shut off everything, and a saturation as well. Here, I'm using one of our off-the-shelf PI block, which have the ability to tune a plant. Let's see first our result without any tuning. So I just used value from my gut instinct, from my past experience. I'm using the ODN technique with the specific PVM block that we have, and we can see that we can simulate 100 milliseconds at 100 kilohertz quite fast, actually. This is usable for control design purposes. We can see that our system reacts, and then there is a huge overshoot. We go down up to 33 volts, and this is not good. We would like to have a much more smooth approach, no overshoot at all. And let's get this tuned. So, as you may know, if you have Simulink Control Design, you can actually click the tune button and it will be trying to linearize the plant, everything that is after the PI block. And in this case, it's going to fail. It's going to fail because we are using a switched linear system with our ideal MOSFET and a piecewise linear diode. But still, they create something that cannot be linearized since there is on and off, on and off, on and off. You cannot fix on a specific operating point to get a new plant model. So what you're going to do? Well, we're going to do what he's suggesting. We can use the plant menu to create or select a new plant. And we're going to click on identify new plant. In this case, we're going to use we fully integrate system identification toolbox within the System Tuner app. So we need just to provide him from I/O data. And in this case, I can have it from my experiment, or I could simply simulate them. Let's change the view to a single one just to see my system identification view. And here I can generate my step function that I want my system to simulate. I do the step at 10 milliseconds and I stop the simulation at 100 milliseconds. And I will step up to around 61% of duty cycle. Here right now, this is my test vector, and I'm gonna automatically split the system, do an open loop step test to 61% of duty cycle. I'm gonna read the error, and now they're gonna, while I start, I will explain, they're gonna need to simulate three times. One with the zero open loop, 1-0, so in order to get the right offset to take away so that they can calculate actually the plant response. So now this is gonna take some second But still, thanks to the fact that we are simulating using this approach, the audience solver forced to take step at the right moment, this is actually not gonna take a lot of time. This, as I said, combines very effectively two toolbox in one app, the System Identification Toolbox and the Simulink Control Design. We're gonna see when the system is done that we're gonna have the open the response to this open loop test as an output signal. Yes, it seems ready. Now it needs to simulate for the last time, and then we are gonna, it's gonna be able to recalculate the output of our plant just by the error and with appropriate input. And now we have it. We can see the output. We can apply and use this input-output response to our system identification. We can close this simulate IO data and go back to the plant identification. We can see a very nice interactive way to create a transfer function based on our input-output. Here now I see that I have some kind of delay here, so I may want to add a delay with a one-pole structure. Then I can click Auto Estimate. It's going to use the algorithm in the System Identification Toolbox to provide me with a good approximation, but you can see that it's not as good. This is due because the system is slightly more complex to be able to approximate with a one-pole transfer function. So let's put two poles. Click again on Auto Estimate, and we can see that we can reach a very good approximation. The SAPIC is a well-known system. It can be approximated with a two-real pole with some delays. We have now a very good match to our input-output. And again, this works with any kind of converter design. So if you have your custom design, you don't need to spend time deriving average system equation in order to do control design and be able to linearize your system. You can use any design as you have it, implement this kind of fast of switch linear simulation, use system identification technique, and get back your transfer function. We can take a look at our transfer function. So we apply this as our new plant. And then we can go back to our reference tracking and see that this time it's going to work. We can see that we are using this ID proc identified system. Double click on it, we can see how the transfer function looks like. And this can actually be used to retrieve any kind of transfer function approximation, as I said, any kind of converter topology. So we would like to be way more robust. We don't want any kind of overshoot. And we are happy maybe to be a bit slower. We don't need a lot of speed. We are happy if we can reach there 40 milliseconds, but without overshoot. So right now we can update the block. And then we can see how the system behaves. Close it. This will have the new value in it. We can simulate and see how our system is behaving right now. You can see that actually is way better. It's behaving like we expect. And this is what I did. And these were actually the result that you saw live in my video of the hardware demonstration. I was simply using the same value I calculated using this technique. It's a very powerful technique. So what have we seen? We tuned based on a system identification technique integrated in the PID Tuner app, works with any topology, any kind of converter, just requires this kind of switch linear simulation. And even better, we now have, for a lot of converter, actually directly average switch option. So if you don't want to use system identification technique, or if you ever working with a traditional DC-DC converter, we provide for you a lot of blocks from since 20A, which are average off the shelf, which can then be linearized and used in your control design without problems.